गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास।
मॉर्निंग सर।
कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन?
यस सर।
ऑल राइट, सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अ क्वेश्चन ऑन योर रिग्रेशन एंड वी वर अबाउट टू स्टार्ट डिफरेंट एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट्स in different terms. So we know that originally what we studied, so I'll just remind you, we studied this regression coefficient y on x as summation xy summation x multiplied by summation y divided by n. Later you multiply this with n. So I am writing the generic expression summation x square minus summation x whole square divided by n. So this was for your regression coefficient y on x. This was your y on x regression coefficient. Similarly, we'll write x on y regression coefficient as bxy is equal to summation xy minus summation x summation y divided by n. Same, the denominator will change a bit. That is your summation y square minus summation y upon n summation y ka whole square. So this was the expression of your regression coefficients. And now we will look at some other formula, some other expressions in different terms for the same regression coefficients. For the same value of this bx and bxy, how we can derive new form of new expression for these regression coefficients. So this topic is important. Why? Because if you learn this, if you remember different expression of regression coefficient, then you will be able to applicate these in different scenarios correctly. So this is going to be case one, when regression coefficients are expressed in terms of covariance and variance. So we learn about this now. All right. So we are not going into the derivation, rather I'll just write the output and I'll explain it. So byx, y on x regression coefficient is simple, which is covariance of x, y in terms of variance of x. This is y on x. And bxy is equal to covariance of xy divided by variance of y. So this is for x on y, this is for y on x. So now you can calculate your regression coefficient for both the regression lines in terms of covariance and variance. So there may be some question, there may be some scenarios when you have standard deviation given to you, covariance or data given to you, and you are asked to calculate this regression lines. And if you keep looking for what you have studied earlier, you won't be able to find the regression coefficient. So you must understand, you must remember यू मस्ट नो दिस एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ कोवेरियंस एंड वेरियंस. अनदर वन, इफ यू आस्क मी टू डिराइव दिस, आई विल ऑल्सो डिराइव इट, बट आई थिंक दैट इज आउट ऑफ योर कंसर्न, आउट ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट सिलेबस, सो आई एम स्टिकिंग टू दिस आउटपुट ओनली. दिस इज वॉट यू विल बी यूजिंग इन दिस सिनेरियोस. नाउ वी विल एक्सप्रेस दिस रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट्स अगेन, बट दिस टाइम इन टर्म्स ऑफ deviations of x series and y from their respective means. So this is not something you have not heard before. You know that in many cases we use this deviation from means concept. So how will express in terms of deviation of x and y from their respective means? So we all know that we can express this covariance in the form of, if you remember, then what we did in to calculate the covariance, we used to do summation small xy, you remember, divided by, we used to find out this with respect to n. So the same expression will not be derived further to look in terms of deviation of x and y from their respective mean. How we do it? So this is going to be your byx is equal to summation of x minus x bar multiplied by summation of, this is y minus y bar, xy हो गया small xy, divided by summation x minus x bar का whole square. This is for byx. Then again bxy, summation of x minus x bar and y minus y bar will remain same. Only the denominator will get changed, that will be your summation of y minus y bar whole square. So these are two regression coefficients when expressed in terms of deviations taken from their respective means. If you remember previous classes, if you are able to recall the previous classes, then these are not a problem for you. Because what we are doing is, we are just deriving new formulas by using the previous definitions. And in the beginning, I told you that good mean were, or good averages, or good measure were able to be used in further mathematical treatment. And that is what we are doing. हम लोग उसी mean से regression तक आ गए हैं. So that is the importance of your previous classes. In the third scenario, most used scenario, the regression coefficients will be expressed in terms of your correlation coefficient, which is R, standard deviation for both the series, standard deviation for X and standard deviation for Y. Since correlation was calculated using covariance, so it means we can also derive the same covariance, the case number one expression, in terms of R. So this is going to be your B y x will be R मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द रेशियो ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन वाई एंड एक्स एंड बी एक्स वाई विल बी अगेन आर मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द रेशियो ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ एक्स एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ वाई. सो दिस इज एक्स ऑन वाई, दिस इज वाई ऑन एक्स. सो दीज थ्री एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द न्यू सिनेरियोज एंड फाइंडिंग आउट द वैल्यूज. सो लेट अस प्रैक्टिस सम क्वेश्चंस एंड विल जस्ट डिराइव देम, विल नॉट सॉल्व देम फुली बिकॉज दैट विल बी योर टास्क एट योर होम. Question says, okay, the mean is given for both the variables. This is 20 and standard deviation of x is 20, standard deviation for y is again 20 and covariance for x comma y is equal to minus 100. Now find correlation coefficient and byx bxy. So there are two parts of the question. You have to find the correlation coefficient and regression coefficient. Now if you remember how to calculate the correlation coefficient, क्या आप में से कोई जानता है, याद है किसी को? When you look back to your previous chapters, yes?
The covariance of x and y upon standard deviation of x and the standard deviation of
perfect,
y.
Perfect. So this R is going to be your covariance of xy and this. And luckily we have all the values. So when you attempt any such question, you should have all the expression in your mind. And you can also write these expression to the right side of your answer sheet. When if you are appearing for the offline examination, you see that we can write the rough section on the right. So you can roughly write the expressions here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, number of expressions you remember at that time, and you can relate which variable is missing and which formula needs to be applied here, and you can apply the formula then. So you find that regression has its relationship with the correlation. Why? Because of the existence of covariance in the regression, and that will be determined by using the measure of dispersion. So it means all these statistics are related to each other. Okay, so this is going to be your covariance is given as minus 100. Standard deviation is given as 20 into 20. We can calculate it. So this is minus 1 upon 4, which is 1/4, which is 25%. So minus 2.25 is your R is given, negative correlation 0.25. Now it is easy. If you remember the exact third expression, BYX can be calculated using R and standard deviation. Like this, R standard deviation of Y upon X, and BXY can be calculated as R B standard deviation X standard deviation Y. So these are the two expressions which are important, and you'll be able to use these if only you remember the expression. Another important question. Yes.
To calculate BYX, we can use this formula also, the first one, by the help of covariance and variance.
Yes. This one, exactly. You can do
yes,
it.
Sir.
You can do it. Yeah, okay, this is this can also be applied. See, all these three expressions are derived from one. These are equal. All right.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So when you look at this, if it is square, you see that this is nothing but r into standard deviation of y. So you'll find it like these things are related, and since in the first step we have calculated this r, so I use this r in the calculation of second. Why? Because this question is simple, all the information is given. There may be other questions where all these information is missing. So we have not used mean in this case, right? We just use these three elements and we calculated the weights. Now this question, it may take time. So it is given that the coefficient of correlation is given. Correlation between x and y is given. This says that correlation between husband's age and wife age, इन दोनों के बीच का correlation is given as 0.8, that is positive. And the average of husband's age, average of husband's age was 25 years and wife's average was 22 years. Standard deviation is given hai husband's age ka, and the standard deviation were 4 and 5 respectively. You need to calculate expected age of husband when wife's age is 18 years, and expected age of wife when husband's age is 32 years. Can anyone explain me this, how we are going to solve it? If you explain it right, then I will leave it and we'll move on.
So in this question, first we will calculate the regression coefficient, and then by putting the formula of y minus mean is equal to byx x minus mean,
yes,
we will derive the two equations, and then in the value of to calculate y, in the value of x we will put 18 years, and to calculate y we will put the age of 32
great, great.
Years.
It means you know
Am
the
I
degree.
Right?
Yeah, perfect, perfect. So what we'll do is we'll first write like H as Y and husband as Y and wife as X. Then we know to calculate, to predict the value of H, we need Y on X equation, and for this, to prediction the of the wife age, we need X on Y. To calculate Y on X, we'll be calculating this BYX first, and for this BXY first. Fine. And then we have the regression equation. Regression equation, you put the value and you'll get the predicted value for the unknown, right? That's what you were saying?
Yes, sir.
All right. So next is another question. So we'll just quickly, if you are doing it quickly, it means you are having good practice. Another question. This question is about, you need to find out most likely production. So again, it is about forecasting corresponding to the rainfall of 40 centimeter from the following data. Okay, so now the examiner wants you to calculate the production, to forecast the production when the rainfall is 40 centimeter. But you cannot do this forecasting until you have some past data. And what will you ask of the past data? You will ask, okay, tell me the average rainfall and average production. Then you will say, okay, rainfall production is okay, but there may be some deviation from the actual means. So you will say, tell me the standard deviation. और इन दोनों में कोई अगर आपने कोरिलेशन निकाला हुआ है तो उसको भी बता दीजिए. सो दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इज गिवन टू यू, इट सेज दैट एवरेज रेनफॉल एवरेज प्रोडक्शन. तो एवरेज जो है यहाँ पर 30 सेंटीमीटर का रेनफॉल होता है और एवरेज प्रोडक्शन यहाँ पर 500 केजी का होता है. फिर आपने पूछा स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन बताइए, रेनफॉल में जो है 5 सेंटीमीटर का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन पाया गया एंड यू नो व्हाट स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज. और प्रोडक्शन में 100 केजी का डेविएशन पाया गया. एंड यू विल से ओके टेल मी द आर, एंड आर इज इट सेज द 0.8, इट मीन देर इज अ गुड रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द रेनफॉल एंड द प्रोडक्शन. सो नाउ यू हैव दीज वेरिएबल्स, कैन वी नाउ कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ प्रोडक्शन फ्रॉम द रेनफॉल. So we say that production is y and rainfall is x, and we need to calculate the y on x. Byx चाहिए होगा और आपके पास जो equation है आपको उसको भी use करना पड़ेगा. So you have all these details, you just need to put these values and see which expression is going to be used here.
So that the y minus y mean is equal to 1.
Yeah. So you can calculate. This is x bar and y bar. This is both are given. So you can use these expressions and calculate the value for the expected production. So since the basic characteristics of regression, you are aware of this now. And we know that how this mean, what this mean is, and we can call it as central tendency. We know what is this standard deviation, which is from dispersion. Then we try to calculate the relationship, the correlation R, which is about correlation. Then we calculate the prediction regression, and if you understand that central tendency is done, dispersion is done, correlation is done, we are doing this regression. So how these values are going to impact my prediction? So in this chapter we are also using the central tendency, dispersion techniques, correlation measures. So this complete the cycle of your forecasting. This complete the cycle of your finding the cause and effect relationship. Moving on, we need to understand few properties. What are these properties? Properties like we studied for the standard deviation, for the correlation, we have some properties of the regression coefficients also. So in regression, most important are regression coefficients. That's all who do the job. Property number one. Properties of beta, you call it either byx or bxy, इसको कई जगह पर beta भी कहा गया है. Now, first property is that the coefficient of regression, coefficient of correlation, both the coefficient will have same sign. So it says that the coefficient of correlation, which means R, and the two regression coefficients, we know ये two regression coefficients कौन से हैं, either byx or bxy will have same signs. So these two are going to have same sign. Next property is the two regression coefficient. If we calculate the geometric mean, that will be the correlation. So it can be written as that बी वेन बी वाई एक्स गेट्स मल्टीप्लाइड विद बी एक्स वाई दिस विल बी स्क्वायर ऑफ कोरिलेशन और ऑल्सो आर विल बी इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस बी वाई एक्स एंड बी एक्स वाई. सो दिस इज ज्योमेट्रिक मीन ऑफ योर कोरिलेशन इज द ज्योमेट्रिक मीन ऑफ टू रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट्स. दिस प्रॉपर्टी इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज यू विल फाइंड मेनी क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दिस. दे से ओके यू हैव आर, यू हैव दिस वन रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट, कैलकुलेट द अदर. सो यू विल बी एबल टू कैलकुलेट ओनली वेन यू नो दिस रिलेशनशिप. So in this whole statistics subject, you must have studied the properties, and in the previous ones also, we found that there were some relationships which were used to calculate the value of the unknown. Similarly, this is also an important point to understand. Property number third. It says if one of the regression coefficients is greater than unity, if it is greater than unity, the other must be less than unity. अगर आपकी एक रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट जो है वो एक से ज्यादा है तो दूसरा जो है वो एक से कम ही होगा. और इसका सीधा सीधा डेरिवेशन जो है वो ज्योमेट्रिक मीन वाले कैरेक्टरिस्टिक से ही है. प्रॉपर्टी नंबर फोर इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस प्रॉपर्टी नंबर फोर सेज दैट द रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट्स आर independent of change in origin but not of scale. I hope you remember this same property shared by which measure. And that measure has an important impact on this regression. So these four properties are most important properties when you study regression coefficients. So once we discuss the properties, we have to do some questions based on the properties, but I would like to skip that part. I'll keep that part for the next class and we'll be doing more questions on the regressions in the next class. Even we'll end this chapter in the next class. But before we finish, we have to do another job. We have to do one more type of expression, one more type of conceptual understanding before moving to the practice session. And that will be a case of determining the line of regression. Determining the line of regression of y on x and that of x on y out of the given two regression lines. So the case says that there will be two equations. So I'll write those equations, that there will be two equations be like this: x plus 2y is equal to 5 and 2x plus 3y is equal to 8. These are the two equations and you need to determine which one of them is y on x and which one of them is x on y. which is x on y, and which is y on x. So how we determine it? We are going to use the property here. So we'll assume any one of these two regression lines as y on x and the other as x on y. So this will work on the assumption. We'll assume any one of the two regression line as y on x. So I assume that this is y on x and this is x on y. So now this is y on x, so I'll rewrite this equation as, this equation is given as x plus 2y is equal to 5. I'll write it as 2y is equal to 5 minus x and y is equal to 5 upon 2 minus x upon 2. So your y is equal to minus x upon 2 plus 5 upon 2. Again, I hope you get this point. मैंने इसको y on x माना है. I have assumed this equation as y on x. तो y on x को हम express कैसे करते हैं? y is equal to की form में. और जो x के साथ coefficient है, this is going to be your beta value. This is byx. कितना? माइनस वन बाय टू. वाई की इक्वेशन देखिए, उसमें जो वैल्यू एक्स के साथ है, जो एक्स का कोफिशियंट है, जो स्लोप दिखा रहा है एक्स का, दैट इज योर बीटा, बीटा फॉर वाई ऑन एक्स. सिमिलरली विल डू इट फॉर दिस आल्सो. सो दिस टू एक्स प्लस थ्री वाई इज इक्वल टू एट. विल राइट इट एज टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू एट माइनस थ्री वाई. X is equal to 4 minus 3 by 4y, and this x is equal to minus 3 by 4y plus 4. So here beta bxy is equal to minus 3 by 4. Now we'll use the property. Property says that if we multiply this byx multiplied by bxy, it will be negative 1 or less than 1 or equal to 1. Not negative, it is less than equal to 1. If this is correct, it means your assumption is correct. So if this is correct, it means your assumption is correct. So we'll check it. You multiply these two. When you multiply these two, what you get? Byx multiplied by bxy will be minus 1 upon 2 multiplied by minus 3 by 4. And this is your 3 by 4, positive 3 by 4, which is less than equal to 1, which is less than 1. So since this condition is satisfied, it means that the first equation was correct. We assumed it correct. So y on x equation, हमारे पास क्या थी? X plus 2y is equal to 5, और x on y हमारे पास है 2x plus 3y is equal to 8. So this is done now. So this is all for the conceptual understanding, and there are some questions left on the basis of these, and we'll do those questions in the next class. So tomorrow's class will be the last class for your regression. So now, for now, bid my thanks. For tomorrow's class, you must be prepared. with all the concepts, with all the understandings, you should know all the expressions, only then we'll be able to do those questions. If you study proper, then we'll be able to do as many questions as we can. Maximum number of questions we'll be able to solve if you understand and if you practice on the formulas and expressions. Thank you.